Flat earthers always claim that globe earthers are indoctrinated from childhood on. At the same time, they claim that perspective is the cause of many observations. They don't realize that, when it comes to perspective, they always have been indoctrinated with a special kind of perspective, the artist's perspective. Artist's perspective is an approximation of how reality in three dimensions looks like on a two-dimensional surface, more or less realistically. In order to accomplish this, it uses three assumptions. The first assumption is that the world is flat. The second assumption is that there is a thing called a vanishing point, where parallel lines cross. The third assumption is that vanishing points lie on the horizon. The first assumption makes every argument based on perspective, the artist way to demonstrate that the world is flat, quod non, invalid, because it makes it a begging the question fallacy. The other two assumptions are dead wrong. Let me first show how perspective in artists' drawings work. I'll do two-point perspective only, because that deals with the horizon. First, you draw an horizontal line, the horizon. Then, you choose two vanishing points. Then, you draw a vertical line that is the rib of the cube we are going to draw. You connect the top and the bottom points of that line with both the vanishing points. Then, you draw the cube. The placement of the other two visible ribs you estimate visually. Now you have to draw the same cube next to the previous one. There is a trick for that. I'll show it first in orthogonal view. You draw a line from the top corner of the view to halfway up the opposite rib and extend that line to the extension of the bottom rib. The second cube fits between the first cube and the crossing of the two lines you have just drawn. In perspective view, it looks like this. And you can repeat that principle infinitely. However, all of these pictures are made with the assumption that the vanishing points lie on the horizon. This is observably not the case, as can be seen in these pictures. And the previous pictures made by hand are all made with the assumption that parallel lines cross at the vanishing point. This also cannot be true, because parallel lines never cross in reality. In that respect, SketchUp doesn't make that mistake. SketchUp is a program where you build a real three-dimensional model, and in a real three-dimensional model, parallel lines do not cross, not even in perspective view. The perspective lines from a row of cubes 1 kilometer long don't cross, not even when you extend them to 100 kilometers. With the lens first set at 100 millimeters, then at 500 millimeters, then 1000 millimeters, and then at 2000 millimeters, the maximum zoom capacity of the software, you can clearly see that the lines do not cross. And on top of that, if you change the surface of the cube in bricks, you can see at a focal length of 2000 millimeter that at 100 kilometers the individual bricks become indistinguishable from each other. They blend into one surface of gray, but the bottom of the cube keeps on being below the horizon. It never disappears. That's because the vanishing point in reality doesn't exist. Nothing vanishes. The argument that the bricks at the bottom disappear before the top ones is nonsense, as I have demonstrated in my video Flat Earth Nonsense 52, Sleeping Warrior and Israeli Criterion. All of the bricks just can be distinguished from each other, but they don't disappear. And it need to be said SketchUp makes its 3D models on a flat plane, not on a globe. So everything I show to demonstrate what is happening in perspective, I show as if we were living on a flat plane. Quod non. So everything flat earthers say that is based on a vanishing point, converging lines, field of view, acute angles, the horizon, and what have you in perspective, is based on the indoctrination they had when learning to draw in perspective. And it is not reality. It looks nice, but it is just wrong.